Thank you, Madam Speaker. Because I won't be here this afternoon, I would like to take a moment to speak on two significant missing and murdered Indigenous women bills coming to the floor today, including S-982, the Not Invisible Act, and S-227, Savannah's Act. Thank you to the Majority Leader, Mr. Hoyer, for ensuring these bills are heard today and highlighting this critical issue that has been overlooked for too long. First, S-982, the Not Invisible Act, introduced by Senator Cortez Masto of Nevada, will help combat the longstanding missing and murdered Indigenous women crisis. This bill will establish an advisory committee on violent crime to make recommendations to the Department of the Interior and Department of Justice to establish best practices to combat the epidemic of missing persons, murder, and trafficking of Native Americans and Alaska Natives. It will also create a point person within the Bureau of Indian Affairs charged with improving coordination of violent crime prevention efforts across federal agencies. All this work will be undertaken with an understanding of the unique challenges faced by tribal communities when combating crime, violence, and human trafficking. The advisory committee will be comprised of local law enforcement, federal partners, service providers, and most importantly, survivors and tribal leaders. This bill is about including Indigenous voices by putting Native American survivors in the driver's seat on the crisis of missing and murdered Indigenous women that has plagued tribal communities for centuries. The Not Invisible is about elevating Indigenous voices because survivors of these horrific crimes and tribal leaders know what's best for their own communities. Throughout history, the federal government has told tribes and Native people how they should approach issues on their own lands without intentionally including their voices. And often these one-sided solutions have fallen short or no real action was taken. I am here today to tell you that photo ops and empty promises are no longer enough. While there are many federal programs and resources that can be used to combat violent crimes in Indian country, there is no overarching plan or strategy to do so. There is little awareness or coordination of services, and federal resources may not consider the actual needs of American Indians and Alaska Natives. These unique cultural considerations and the complex framework of criminal jurisdiction on tribal lands simply cannot be navigated by a one-size-fits-all approach. More importantly, a real solution will never be found without the voices of Indigenous survivors, which is what is so special about this bill. The crisis of missing, murdered, and trafficked Native women has devastated families and communities, but have gone unaddressed throughout history. These losses are an open wound in our tribal communities and add to the generational trauma facing Native American families that many of us have experienced. That is why my dear friends and colleagues, Representatives Tom Cole, Sharice Davids, and Mark Wayne Mullen, helped me introduce this bill in the House as the first bill in history to be sponsored by four federally recognized tribal members of the Pueblo of Laguna, the Chickasaw Nation, the Ho-Chunk Nation, and the Cherokee Nation, respectively. Enactment of S-982 will be one step toward finally acknowledging the pain that our families have felt and giving our survivors the platform that they need to begin healing the open wound Native American people, especially our women, have felt in this country for so long. My hope is that together we can use the Not Invisible Act to do just that, not be invisible anymore. The second bill that I would like to highlight is S-227, Savannah's Act. This bill was introduced by Senator Murkowski and is named in honor of Savanna Greywind, who was a 22-year-old member of the Spirit Lake Tribe. Savanna was 8 months pregnant when she was tragically murdered in August of 2017. At the time of her death, she had recently gotten a job as a nursing assistant and was looking forward to starting her family by welcoming her first child with her partner, Ashton, in North Dakota. However, this ended abruptly when Savannah was brutally strangled after having her child removed from her belly in a violent attack. Savannah was just one of the many Native American women who have been victims of the silent crisis of missing and murdered Indigenous women in the United States. Native women experience murder rates 10 times higher than the national average, and murder is the third leading cause of death for American Indians and Alaska Natives. 84% of Native women endure violence during their lifetime, and they are twice as likely to experience sexual assault or rape in their lifetimes than any other group. This is unacceptable. Even though these alarming rates persist, there are no reliable systems available to track this data or know exactly how many Native American women and girls go missing each year, because the databases that hold statistics of these cases are outdated, and there is a lack of coordination between local, state, and tribal law enforcement agencies. Savannah's Act addresses these discrepancies to find practical solutions to address the epidemic of missing and murdered Indigenous women by improving tribes' access to federal crime information databases, requiring the United States to track and publish data relating to the disappearance of our women, and providing training and technical assistance to tribal law enforcement agencies to adequately respond to these cases. I thank Representative Norma Torres for inviting me to co-lead this critical piece of legislation to help improve data collection of Indigenous women where none exists, to help law enforcement follow-up rates and response times for cases that take place on and off tribal lands. Most importantly, this bill will help develop new guidelines to improve law enforcement communications with families of victims to disseminate information of cases involving their loved ones, which is crucial because many times no efforts are made to update families currently. To the former partner of Savannah Ashton Matheny and her daughter, Hazley Jo, who turned 3 1 month ago today, I would like to send my sincerest condolences to your family. While the passage of this bill will never make up for your devastating loss, I hope that it brings honor to your mother and know that it will impact generations to come. I am proud to be the sponsor and co-lead of the House versions of S-982, Not Invisible Act, and S-227, Savannah's Act, to help address the crisis of missing and murdered Indigenous women. I urge my colleagues to join me in supporting both of these bills, and I reserve the balance of my time.